Sir, so today I am going to upload this last video from this chapter, the British Raj and the First War of the Independence. Okay. So the first setting, you can see the British control. As you all know that East India Company, you know, of the England, you know, used the wealth which was taken from the India, and it was used to fund the industrial revolution that was, you know, happening in the Britain or the England. And definitely British also needed, you know, a steady supply of the raw material so that they can produce much more cotton cloth and also a market. So India was the best option. So gradually, you know, British turned ruler from the traders. Now British also took advantages because, you know, the main Mughal empire was declining. So several regional empires like Rajasthan, Bengal, Maharashtra, you know, emerge as the independent dynasty. So British took these opportunities and started gaining control over India. So the first step to control over India, that was the Battle of Plassey. As you all know that 1757, it was fought between Robert Clive and the Sirajuddaulah. Sirajuddaulah defeated these battles, and finally the Bengal was captured by the East India Company or the British. Understood? The second, discontent among Indians. And Indian, we know, become very unhappy and dissatisfied. There were several results. I have pointed out this, all that things, you know, like, you know, point number one, company used unfair means to get rich. That means, you know, in illegal way, they were trading to earn more profit. And even point number two, even they forced the farmers, because Bengals were under control of the British, so they forced the farmers to start the indigo cultivation to earn more and more money. But, you know, as you all know that where you will start the indigo cultivation on that land, up to 10 to 15 years, you will not be able to cultivate any other food crops. So farmers, you know, became poorer and the poorer, and they were suffering without food. Point number three, you know, which cotton cloth were produced in the industries of the Britain, they tried to sell in India, and definitely it was a very cheaper and better quality than Indian cloth. So who were involved in this Indian handloom industries, like, you know, traders, bankers, common people, weavers, they suffered a lot. And, you know, the British in this way ruined the Indian handloom industries. Point number five, British made, you know, unjust laws, you know, to control over the fully control over the India. For example, one law was there that if a ruler, you know, died without natural heir or the son, then definitely British would capture the whole kingdom. So in that way, many kingdoms were captured. So most of the Indians were unhappy and dissatisfied. As a result, you know, after 1757, 100 years, 1857, we saw the revolt, or you can say the uprising by the Indian soldiers. Because as you all know, the meaning of the revolt or the uprising, you know, revolt means if you a group of people or most of the people were against the law of the government, then it is called the revolt or the uprising. So Indian soldiers started revolt against the now the next point, you know, the revolt of 1857, the First War of Independence. So we'll talk about the reasons. As you all know that we have already explained in the Google Meet classes and here also that there are several reasons, but the main point was, you know, before 1857, several months of the tensions, you know, were there around the army barracks. What were the reasons, or what are the problems? Because British introduced the Enfield rifle for the British Indian Army. Okay, but you know, as you all know that if you want to shoot someone or something, then you need a cartouche or the bullet, right? So if you load these rifles, then you have to buy it off the ends of the greases cartridges, right? And these greases or grease were made up of the fat of the pig and the cow. And definitely, as you all know, that Sikh, Hindus, Muslims were present in the British Indian Army. So definitely it angered them, because for the Hindus, cow were very sacred, and for the Muslim, pigs were unclean. So that's why they were not related to this kind of thing. So it was against their religions. Followed? These are the reasons. Now, how this revolt was broke out? Point number one, 29th March, Mangal Pandey, he was the soldiers in Barakpur, is very near to the Kolkata. He started the revolt and he killed the British officer on that area, right? Point number two, 8th April, he was arrested, he caught, and he was hanged by the British. This incident actually triggered. So all the Indian soldiers joined this revolt and started killing the British officers. Point number three, 10th May, soldiers of the Meerut in Uttar Pradesh actually, you know, killed all the British officers and recaptured the Meerut from the British. And they, point number four, 11th May, that means the next day they marched to the Delhi. You know, as we all know, the Delhi was the capital city. So if you would capture, the Delhi, that means you would be, you know, the leaders or the rulers of the India, the whole India, right? So they marched to the Delhi and persuaded or requested this last Mughals ruler, second Bahadur Shah Zafar, to be the leader. Okay, so he was chosen as the leaders of the revolt, of this revolt. Now the next point, several Indian local leaders also joined, like Jhansi Ki Rani Lakshmi Bai Ji, Nana Sahib, Tatiya Topi, Begum Hazrat Mahal, etc. Right? Even they sacrifices their life to save their motherland. They sacrifices their life for our freedoms. Jhansi Ki Rani Lakshmi Bai Ji was killed. You know, Nana Sahib Tatiya Topi was hanged. So finally, British defeated India or Indian soldiers. Why? Because British had, you know, superior knowledge of the weapons. So that's why when they use this kind of knowledge, you know, Indian soldiers were defeated. Finally, in the year of 1858, Britain government or the England government decided that to end the rule of East India Company in India, and it would be under direct control of the Britain Queen, Queen Elizabeth I, I think. So she would rule directly India. And she appointed one officer. His name was Viceroy. The post name was Viceroy. Viceroy means the deputy or the assistant of the Queen. He would come to India and he would rule on behalf of the Queen. Understood? So, and in that way, you know, this India became the under control directly of the Britain. Now, we have lost this battle, we have lost this revolt, definitely, but we have learned many things from this revolt, because it gave inspiration, motivation, positivity to the Indians that we can also, if we be together or if we be united, then definitely we can, you know, defeat the British and force to leave the India. Finally, in the year of 1947, we got the independence because of these kind of reasons. Understood? So if you have any queries, any problems, you can contact with me. And thank you very much. So I'm ending this video lessons in here.